They had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Just like the hands on the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm dropping the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't wanna bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go lose, and then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break a bone, me and myself top two. I blow away the competition like a bowl of hot soup. And there's no catch, I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB, I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 4-4. All you went first, you last. Little boy, that's facts. I'ma grow that cash to my money.
You know what? Let me stop.
Yeah, I use a dub. I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. I'ma act a fool with this. I'ma act a fool with this. I turn the knob, camera assist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating round here. I'm the goat, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I'm with the Cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. I'ma act a fool with this. I'ma act a fool with this. I'ma act a fool with this. Okay. Then I hit that. Ready for this. Since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these eyes ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe for the cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only winning is exception on my cool. Ain't no dub, ain't no L. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. I'ma act a fool with this. I'ma act a fool with this. I'ma act a fool with this.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with the Seattle Seahawks. The kicker for the Saints, Will Lutz, has it teed up, and here we go from New Orleans. This is DJ Reed returning. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
So first and 10 now from the 30. From the shotgun, Wilson. And this is caught. It's Greg Olsen. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
First down.
Wilson, after the play fake to Carson. And he's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. Territory.
Complete.
It's a big play there for Seattle. And even 50 yards. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
6-yard line. It's a gain of a yard. Brings up second and goal.
on second down now. It's Carson.
And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the two.
This opening drive has taken him to the two, but now they come up on a third and goal. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. Dancing to his... And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. They were looking to pass the ball there, but they forgot to account for the man with the football.
Yeah, I can hear people right now saying, well, why don't you have a spy in your defense, someone who will dance with him and go where he goes? Well, oftentimes, if you utilize a spy, you've taken away someone in coverage as well. And oftentimes, the spy, not as athletic as the guy he's trying to keep up with, so he gets defeated anyway.
And he turns third and goal into a touchdown.
At their own 25-yard line.
So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Out of the gun, he'll throw. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. A trial for Sanders, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. Escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about, getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right, a lost opportunity.
Good running there by Kamara on first down as he takes this ahead for a gain of 5.
Jamal Adams there.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. From the gun, it's Breeze. Got him in. He finds Sanders. And he's going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Two veterans, Breeze to Sanders there for a Saints first down. Here's Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
And he'll go down, shy of the 40 at the 41.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
On first and 10, here's Breeze. He throws and he hits the snap out to Thomas. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Into the red zone, it's Breeze. That's caught, it's Thomas. And he's brought down. Another first down as they call his number again. He's got 15 yards here.
I think a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker. And you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry, ball gets tipped in the air. Because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
Looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for first and goal. They'll run. Here's Burton, the fullback. And he takes it across and into the end zone. zone. Touchdown, Saints. Mike Burton taking it in. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And he's got it up and through. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. Will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
On first down, Wilson. They'll run the screen with Carson. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now second and four from the 31.
Second and four at the 31-yard line.
They run it with Carson. And a scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
Carrier. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. It's a gain of a yard. And it's third down.
These two teams all tied after one.
With the score tied 7-7.
Wilson now to throw on third down. Pass complete to DK Metcalf. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. They run for it with Carson. And he will have the first down, but he winds up taking a pretty good shot that time. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. They go play action with Wilson. On the move to his left. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Marcus Davenport, the first rounder out of UTSA with a sack. Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sort of back its head.
Wilson's pass.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. From the gun, it's Wilson. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
Now that's a good bounce back after giving up a touchdown on the opening drive. Just one first down permitted and then out. Obviously no loss of confidence with that defense. And now they get to turn it back to their offense.
This one hits at the three and then bounce into the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 20-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starters' blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now, they're just cutting them to shreds.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Shotgun now for Breeze. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Third and six.
From the gun, it's Breeze. And going deep for Hill. And that will be incomplete.
for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
He was covered by Jamal Adams.
Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. The Seahawks have David Moore back deep. Returning it is Moore. A 55-yard punt that time with a return of about 14. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10.
They're on 31-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
First out to his left. He's going to take off with it. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
The Seahawks first down.
Operating from the gun, Wilson buying time to his left. Now he'll pull it down. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
On second down. It's Carson, and the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. It's a loss of four. Now third down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
On third down, Wilson steps away to his left. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. This is Carson, and he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Seahawks have taken the lead. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
At the 33-yard line.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis. And this time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off by DJ Reed. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
And oh, it's no good. For the second time now in this first half, he's missed an extra point. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
I like that because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle. You know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there, it's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. See if they can get the ball moving again.
See if they can do it here. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Will try again on second down. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 12 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Again, it's Breeze. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Brings up second and 1. At the 40-yard line.
Throwing again on second down. Breeze. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 22-yard line. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Breeze now on first down. Complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2, as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Now a first and 10 at the 11. They'll give him 8 on the play, and it'll make it a second down. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara in the final seconds of the first half, and the Saints have cut it back within a score. And this one through the uprights and good.
Seahawks 20, Saints 14.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Taken in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Final play of the half, it's Wilson. The catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Saints going to go on offense first, and they trail here as we begin quarter number 3. Fielded in the end zone. And we will not see a run back here from Harris. Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, right.
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on to it second down.
5 yard line.
Now Breeze. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
He's here finding Kamara. He's got a first down and inside the midfield. He gets it across the 50 and down to the 48. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Again, they'll throw with Breeze. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 7 yards there on the first down screen play.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Looking to throw again on second down. Breeze. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having three in the first half. It's a run for Kamara, and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. Now Breeze on 3rd down. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And his bid for the first down coming up short as he's tackled at the 25. It'll be a gain of 6, and it'll be 4th down. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on 4th and 1. Running it with a fullback, Burton. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it, but in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
Ready? You're waiting. 5 minutes.
On 1st down, Breeze. He'll get this one underneath to Kamara. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Call that a gain of 5 as the clock ticks inside of 2 minutes to go now in the 3rd. From the 9, 2nd and 5.
Now Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and six.
Third down and six.
From the gun, it's Breeze. And Breeze is intercepted for the third time. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And he will bring this across midfield to the 49-yard line. It was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
Interception. Here's Wilson. Out to the right, he gets it to Lockett. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. That'll pick up the first down for Seattle on a gain of 18.
Seattle.
Wilson after the play fake to Carson. He'll buy some time right. That's going to be caught. And out of bounds all the way down at the three. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. It'll be first and goal when we come back. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Carson, and this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a second and goal. The quick slant caught, and he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Russell Wilson on target to DK Metcalf, and the Seahawks add on to their lead.
Great field position has to be one of the best friends an offense can have. When you don't have very far to go, you should cash it in with points.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Taken in the end zone. And we will not see a run back here from Harris.
At their own 25-yard line.
Set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football. And everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. That's me right there with me.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 15 yards on the play, first down.
First and 10 at the 41-yard line.
Here's Breeze. And brought in by the tight end Cook.
Breeze,
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five at the 46-yard line.
Shotgun now for Breeze. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Breeze going to try and throw on third down. And that is incomplete.
Going with the dime look that time on defense just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. The Saints do snap it. It's Breeze. And it is incomplete. But it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. Wilson going to fake the give and keep it himself. It's a gain of 15, first down Seahawks.
Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane and he keeps it himself there. Worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it. Most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
They'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and ten, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Carson will take the handoff out of the option play. And good running going to get this down close to a first at the Saints 21. 7 yards there and a first down.
A gain of seven. And the Seahawks first.
Now they'll throw it with Wilson being chased out left. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The lines move there. Look like nobody open. Now second down. From the 21, it's second and 10.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second down, there's the option going left. The decision to keep it turns out to be a good one. 11 yards in the first down. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Play action. It's Wilson. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So Breeze going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at the 20.
20-yard line.
So after the INT, it's Breeze. He'll let this thing go for Sanders. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Breeze will try again on second down. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter.
36-yard line.
Working from the gun, it's Breeze. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
Incomplete. Brings up second and 10.
Now, Breeze again. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
Meanwhile, here's a shot for the end zone right away, but it's incomplete. Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Gun. Here's Wilson. And that is caught, but the bank judge right there to say incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf, but now it's third and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he gets halfway there, down to the 1-yard line. Only a yard that time, so now a decision to be made here on fourth and goal. Fourth down, here's Wilson. And no, it's incomplete. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Saints able to come up with a goal line stand.
The result of the play is a turnover on down.
In his own end zone, it's Breeze. He's going to win. Again, his man, complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 35 and the 34. Breeze now on first down. This is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by DJ Reed. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it into the end zone, and you know they could have taken a knee there. But they decided to play this one all the way out, and I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
Extra point up and through by Myers. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. For Seattle. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And we will not see a run back here from Harris.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them.
Now this throw caught left side, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Jared Cook, the tight end, was the target. And now it's second down. Breeze to throw again. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And my goodness, another interception. Trey Flowers picks it.
Can do up here is just shake my head. I mean, 6 interceptions. I cannot imagine what he's thinking between the ears right now.
Well, just think of how it is for his teammates, because after the first few, you know they're going over to him, hey, we'll get him next time. Now they're probably a little bit frustrated.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick, and he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. On themselves here down the stretch. 2 picks now in the fourth quarter, trying to hang on to that lead.
Talk about keeping someone in the game. Instead of being able to shut the door, it's still cracked open because they can come back on you now. The only people are really happy about those picks, any fantasy team that has this defense.
This is complete to Michael Thomas. 14 yards is the pickup. First down, New Orleans. And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left. Throwing on first down is Breeze. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
It's second down and 10.
So now they'll come up on second and 10 once again from the 28. One final try here for Breeze. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. So the victory here for Seattle, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of... But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had 3 takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. I'll be heading to the hotel. Charles, he's off to Bourbon Street.
No, I'm not.
As we say, so long from New Orleans.